Well, I hope you enjoy that kind of little bit of a musical interview, because I mean, I think everyone would hear that song if they start doing this. It's just a natural thing. Now, Saturday, of course, tomorrow, the huge game tomorrow, of course, is England and Switzerland. But it's not as huge as many people think it is, because basically, it's really one-sided. This is like, oh, this is bad. This is really, really bad. I mean, you know, when you look at the games that they've played, you know, 27 games, England won 19, they've drawn 5 and lost 3. First game back in 1933, England won 4-0 away. They lost the next two games, both away as well, for 38 and 47. And then the next win for Switzerland was in 1981. That's the last time Switzerland managed to beat England. The last draw was 2011. Before that, then there were two draws in a row, 98 and 96. Andrew, this should be easy pickings for England if we go on statistics, history, form. But it all depends on who brings it home wrong.
I really hate the way you've just built that up to make it so firm favourites. Every time that happens for England, we're going to win it with footballs coming home and all that nonsense, getting ahead of ourselves. Yeah, I mean, it really should be comfortable. How many times have we said that with England? They are in the quarterfinals of the European Championships. That's a place anybody wants to be. So we can't argue with where we are now. And in the end, tournament football different to anything else. That's why it is so wildly unpredictable, because it doesn't matter how you get there. You just, the first job is to get to the final. Once you get to the final, a bit of luck, a bit of form, have the right mentality, and suddenly you're champions. It does not matter how you get there. If you play wildly entertaining football and get knocked out in the group stages, what on earth have you proven? Yes, you've entertained, and that's what a lot of England fans are siding towards at the moment. The vitriol and negativity towards Gareth Southgate has hit levels way above anything I've ever seen, not since he missed a penalty in the European Championships as a player in 1996. The famous Pizza Hut advert with the paper bag over his head. He was so ashamed. Yes, it should be wild favourites. And I want to believe that the England players will have sat around the table and said, you know what, right, enough is enough. We're all sick of this. The negativity around us, but the responsibility we have at producing this negativity. We've been disjointed all over the place. We're quality players. Get our heads together, get some leaders on the pitch and say, right, we're going to sort this out. We're going to play how we know. We're going to move. We're going to talk to each other, be motivated, be energetic, and get the best out of the players. I think England will win this one. I genuinely do, and it's not because I'm English. And believe me, because I'm English is the reason why I think they wouldn't win, because I'm so negative towards them. But
I mean, they are favourites to go through. Okay, they're favourites. They are odds-on favourites to win tomorrow. It's going to be difficult for them, but still, we have to understand that anything can happen. And the Swiss are not bad. The Swiss are a decent team. They've got a lot of quality players playing in quality leagues and quality teams, and it depends on which England turns up. But again, you would be looking just to go win that. In saying that, we, of course, then the next game, which I think is almost as, well, it is almost as important, of course, as the late game, one that is going to be a little bit tasty, because we saw what happened at the end of the last Turkish match. They can get extremely nasty, of course. They're being fined for some not very nice things their fans did, or one of the players did, excuse me, like making the Grey Wolves symbol. Fine for that. Turkey, of course, they invited, shall we say, or said, here, come here to the German ambassador to explain why there was an issue over. But again, this is not a nice organization. I'll explain in just a moment. They're playing Holland in the late game. Andrew, this is a good one. Holland are very much odds on. Turkey are complete rank outsiders. There are a lot of Turks in the Netherlands, which is a huge diaspora and now, like, you know, third, fourth generation in Germany. So there will be a huge pressure on Turkey. And I was told by a former Dutch international, this is like playing Germany. That's what he said. He said, we really, really want to beat them. What's your quick take on it?
Well, Again, so many of these games in theory have strong favourites. Of course, the Netherlands are strong favourites, but it's still not quite convinced me. Even beating Romania 3-0, like we mentioned, they didn't quite hit top gear, although the moves they put forward were devastatingly fast and incisive. They can cut anybody open. However, Turkey have, let's just say, a lot of experience, even within this tournament, at playing back to the wall as underdogs in a game, playing with little possession. And they dig in, they fight. They are not going to be an easy pushover for the Netherlands. Against Austria, Austria dominated a loss of possession, but when they couldn't quite break through, they got frustrated and Turkey hit them with two set pieces. I don't know whether they'll play exactly the same game plan. Probably they will. There's no point trying to out-Netherlands the Netherlands. They have Cody Gakpo's finding some measure of form. Daniel Marlin was absolutely fantastic in their last 16 game against Romania. He was quick, he was confident, he looked like he wanted the ball. So Netherlands should win. I get a feeling this is going to be very hardly fought in every sense. I think this one might actually go to extra time.
Okay, no, I think that is fair enough. I think it's a good point as well. So, okay, we'll go to a very, very short break. So you're picking Netherlands for this one. We'll go to a very, very short break and then come back with quite an interesting take on some of the absolute horrific fluffery that's been going on in the world of sports. Of course, worse in the, let's just say, the Tour de France. Bye. Right after this.